They told me, ba-rum-pa-pum-pum, a newborn king to see, ba-rum-pa-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-rum-pa-pum-pum.
Well, every year I like to do a Christmas video. I almost didn't, but had a little run-in with the system down here. Got a little heated up, was ready to tell you one story, but now I'm going to tell you a different one. And right now I'm at a restaurant that is open. I think they're doing pretty well. Good for them. As you know, I'm in California and most places have been closed down. So I just wanted to take a deep breath. You know, one of the things that's been hard for me here is I've been flashing back to my life before when I lived in Southern California and how so much is about our appearance, how you look, what you drive, what you do, who you are representing to the world. And for those of you who've been with me, you know, I have a real truck as opposed to all the vehicles around here. And so I've, you know, no longer flying under the radar and got the you're too long and too ugly, get out of the parking lot letter. And I don't want to cause trouble, so I did get overheated, but did not speak it aloud to the powers that be. And I just thought that was such a perfect metaphor for what Christmas is really about and what we're doing this year as we're moving into this crazy moment of time where everything is getting ready to explode one way or the other. And how we're so divided because we're protecting the bubble that we live in, that I'm currently sitting here in Southern California in a super, super bubble. There's nothing real, you know, going on here for most everybody. And how, you know, I'm judgmental about that. They're judgmental about my choices. And, you know, I believe in our ability to get to pick and choose how we want to live, where we want to live. That's why I don't live here anymore. But I thought the contrast between the cars was so striking, I had a whole thing I wanted to do with that. In addition, as you can see, I'm trying to figure out a new way to make videos.
Peace on earth, can it be? Years from now, perhaps we'll see. Our see the day of glory.
But instead, I was trying to pick the music, and I remembered The Little Drummer Boy, which is my favorite because it's really the story of giving what you have from within, not showing the world who you want to be by without. There's just no better story than The Little Drummer Boy to really hit this home. That what is important in this season. And then I found Bing Crosby and David Bowie, two people that are no longer with us, and their harmony. And I just couldn't think of anything more powerful or more fitting for the season to really drive home the point that I wanted to make, in addition to just saying thank you for staying with me this year, for hanging in there, for the Patreon members who supported me, even though I hardly put anything up, how the people, other people have just stepped in, and I don't have a physically rich life, but I have a fabulously wealthy life in terms of knowledge and overcome and meaning for me. And sharing that with you has also been a privilege. You know, you guys' comments these last 6 months have just been phenomenal. And what more really has value? And so as we close out 2020, we don't know if we'll have electricity. We don't know if we'll even have freedom. We don't know if we'll have internet. And we don't know if we'll ever have our traditions again. So embrace this holiday season. Embrace who and what you love. Just make it as powerful and as meaningful as you can, because We don't know, but I think it is our great love that will carry us through beyond this season. And so my goal and my hope and my dream is to be with you again next year, having this same conversation in a brand new way. We'll see how that goes. But until that time, my friends, I really invite you to just breathe. You might want to pause, get a cup of cocoa or something, and just listen to the words. Remember who these people are, and let the story of the little drummer boy sink into your heart for all the people who are losing everything that don't live in the bubble. And some of these bubble people are losing everything. Just remember that their value isn't out there, it's in here. And our challenge this year is to see that within them, the way I want to see it in you, and the way so many of you see it in me. So with that, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. If I don't get to do an official Happy New Year video, deep breath, my friends, and I will see you next time. And don't forget, Freedom says Merry Christmas too.
Hello. You the new butler?
Well, it's been a long time since I've been the new anything.
What's happened to Hudson?
I guess he's changing.
Yeah, he does that a lot, doesn't he? Oh, I'm David Bowie. I live down the road.
Oh.
Sir Percival lets me use his piano when he's not around. He's not around, is he?
I can honestly say I haven't seen him, but come on in.
Come in.
But come on in.
Are you related to Sir Percival?
Well, distantly, yeah.
Oh, you're not the poor relation from America,
right? Gee, news sure travels fast, doesn't it? I'm Bing.
Oh, I'm pleased to meet you. You're the one that sings, right?
Well, right or wrong, I sing either way.
Oh, well, I sing too.
Oh, good. What kind of singing?
Well, mostly the contemporary stuff. Do you like modern music?
Oh, I think it's marvelous. Some of it really fine. But tell me, you ever listen to any of the older fellas?
Oh, yeah, sure. I like John Lennon and the other one with Harry Nilsson.
Ooh, you go back that far, huh?
Oh, yeah, I'm not as young as I look.
None of us is these days.
In fact, I've got a six-year-old son, and he really gets excited around the Christmas holiday mm-hmm. thing.
Do you go in for any of the traditional things in the boy household Christmas time?
Oh, yeah, most of them, really. Presents, tree, decorations. Agent sliding down the chimney.
What?
I was just seeing if you're paying attention. Actually, our family do most of the things that other families do. We sing the same songs.
Do you?
I even have a go at White Christmas.
You too, huh?
And this one. This is my son's favorite. Do you know this one?
Oh, I do indeed. It's a lovely thing.
Kings are wise. They will be able to save Baba.
Please, I've got to get inside to see the kings. You must let me through.
And when Aaron came to the entrance of the stable, he could hardly believe what he saw. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Oh, Your Majesty, you must...
Oh, the player boy.
My lamb has been injured. You must save him.
He is near death. Oh, lad, there is nothing I can do.
But you are a king.
A mortal king only. But there is a king among kings who would save your little friend.
The babe? I do not understand.
It is not necessary that you understand. Go to him.
But I have no gift to bring.
Go. look upon the newborn king. And as Aaron looked at the babe, he thought it was the most beautiful sight he had ever seen.
And yet, there is something more about him. So much more.
Your gift, little drummer boy, given out of the simple desperation of a pure love, is the one favored above all. See?
Aaron's heart was filled with joy and love. And he knew at last that the hate he had carried there was wrong, as all hatred will ever be wrong. For more powerful, more beautiful by far than all the eons of sadness and cruelty and desolation which had come before, was that one tiny crystalline second of laughter. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Child and your child too.
I'll sing my day of glory. I play my day.
Live in peace again, and peace on earth, can it be?